Good afternoon. We are on the 1st of March, Tuesday. It is 14:39. I would like to dedicate all these prayers today. I was up until 4 a.m. praying and also printing off photographs of my neighbour Tom at last year's birthday party of Millie, who was 102 that day. Tom is not. He's in his early 80s. He's been in hospital 1 week, one day. Last night, he had an operation. Serious, the doctors have actually said he needs a miracle. So I'm asking you all, please, to join me in prayer. If it's God's holy will, Tom will have that miracle and live. He is fighting for his life. His family were allowed to visit. They're constantly there. His son took all the grandchildren, particularly the one who's been accepted in 3 universities to become a doctor. He's only 17 and he's very, very bright. He's chosen the university he wishes to go to out of the 3, which all accepted him. Because he is bright, he wants to be a surgeon. Well, the surgeons worked on Tom last night. One lung collapsed. He has sepsis now. He has a broken rib or cracked rib. He collapsed in his bedsit. He has a bedsit. I have a 1-bed flat. We're very close, in the sense that every week we go shopping to Lidl with his son. And he's such a joker. He cracks jokes with everybody and he sits in the lounge and everybody knows him. They might not all know me because I don't spend as much time there as Tom's there all the time in the waking hours. So he's already being missed. So I beg you all, please join me in the prayers and ask God if he would be so generous, compassionate and merciful to give Tom a miracle, because that is all that can help him now, a miracle. The doctors have done all they can, and I'm sure you all know the dangers of what happens with sepsis. All the organs start breaking down and everything. And it's a very sad time because he's a very, very well-loved man. Irish. That's why I like him so much. He reminds me of James's father. So all these prayers today, the healing prayers for every day. Yesterday's St. Augustine, because I didn't get to do it. There were issues with the computer again and all sorts of things come and attack me because of what I do. I had to take it all apart, and plug everything back in again and tighten things. And yes, so these things happen, you know. I'm sure they don't happen to other people who aren't doing what I do. So anyway, I'm going to begin with a few prayers and do the healing prayers first. And I will add a day that's missing, because we're not in leap year, are we? We've gone from 28th to the 1st. So I might actually combine what would have been the 29th with the 1st, if you don't mind. Okay, so we'll begin now. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Come, Holy Spirit, fill the hearts of your faithful, and kindle in them the fire of your love. Send forth your Spirit, and they shall be created, and you shall renew the face of the earth. Angel of God, my guardian dear, to whom God's love commits me here, ever this day be at my side to light and guard, to rule and guide. Amen. Holy Michael, Archangel, defend me in this day of battle. Be my safeguard against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, I humbly pray. And do thou, Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, thrust down to hell Satan and all the wicked evil spirits who wander through the world for the ruin of souls. Amen. The first reading is taken from Psalm 65, verse 3, for March the 1st, 2022. To you, all flesh must come. The reflection. Life is a journey to God, and all must give account of their years to the Lord. However, he is available to heal us so that we are most prepared to face our review of life. How good God is to bless us with healing, especially spiritual healing, so that we can grow in love of him and all people. The prayer for the 1st of March 2022. Lord, increase my love for you and for my family and Tom's family and all my listeners' families today, and give us greater openness in love to all people. Amen. I'm going to continue with the healing prayer for if we had a leap year, the 29th of February, and the reading is taken from Psalm 65 verse 5, and it is just a couple of lines. Blessed is the one whom you choose and invite to dwell in your courts. The reflection. All people are religious by nature and yearn for a relationship with God. We see this especially in children. One of the blessings of the Holy Temple, God's dwelling, is love. Praise and worship in the temple open us to God's love, which gives us a deep satisfaction and love for God our Father. The prayer for the 29th of February, which isn't happening this year. Holy Spirit, inspire me to become like a little child and have a great love for praise and worship, so that I may have security and confidence in God's love. And Lord, we ask for you to have mercy and compassion on Tom Ruin, if it's your wish to heal him. We ask in all humility for a miracle to restore his health and his life. In Jesus Christ's holy name, amen. I will use a few more little prayers from the Catholic Christianity book. The heart of Christianity, however, is the belief that God has spoken to us in human history by sending us his Son. He has not left us alone. He has revealed himself to us. We do not have to go round in circles trying to solve everything ourselves. He has come to our help. The idea that Christians claim to know the truth about God will sound arrogant or even fundamentalist to many people, but in fact, there is a kind of humility behind this claim. It is not that Christians as people are special, far from it. It is that they've been given the most extraordinary gift, the knowledge of Jesus Christ, and their desire is simply to share that gift with others. It is Jesus himself who taught that he is the way to God and the truth and the life. The Christian message What then is the Christian message? It is this, that God is love. His love created and sustains the whole universe. His love brings into being every human life. We were meant to live in peace, so we pray for Ukraine and Russia to have peace with God and with each other. But this peace was broken through hatred and sin. In the fullness of time, God sent his only Son, Jesus Christ, to be our Saviour. He came into the world to reveal the love and mercy of God and to lead us to the Father. Through him, we can find peace with God and with each other. His death on the cross brings us forgiveness. His resurrection on the third day and his ascension to heaven give us the hope of an astonishing new life, and the gift of the Holy Spirit allows us to share in that life, even now on this earth, through faith and through belonging to the church. You may not be convinced of these ideas, but at least you can see that the heart of Christianity is not a theory or a program, but a person, Jesus Christ, a person we can come to know above all through faith, which is a gift. The Beatitudes, I will finish with those. How blessed are the poor in spirit. The kingdom of heaven is theirs. Blessed are the gentle. They shall have the earth as inheritance. Blessed are those who mourn. They shall be comforted. And Lord, I pray that Tom's family don't have to mourn yet, if you'd grant him a little longer life. He's fighting to live. Please help him to live, if it is your holy will. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for uprightness. They shall have their fill. Blessed are the merciful. They shall have mercy shown them. Blessed are the pure in heart. They shall see God. Blessed are the peacemakers. May there be peacemakers in Ukraine and Russia and the world. They shall be recognized as children of God. Blessed are those who are persecuted in the cause of uprightness. The kingdom of heaven is theirs. Blessed are you when people abuse you and persecute you and speak all kinds of calumny against you falsely on my account, the account of Jesus Christ. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward will be great in heaven. You are the light of the world. A city built on a hilltop cannot be hidden. No one lights a lamp to put it under a tub. They put it on a lampstand where it shines for everyone in the house. In the same way, your light must shine in people's sight, so that seeing your good work, they may give praise to your Father in heaven. God bless you all. Please pray for Tom and his family, and we need a miracle. So I beg you all to join me. And I thank you in advance. And thank you for listening. Thank you for all your comments and sharing. God bless the rest of your day. I'm sending you prayers of healing and peace. A peace which only God can give. And God bless. And thank you once again for listening. May you always be happy and joyful in the Lord, no matter your circumstances. Trust in God. He is in control of all of us and every situation. Thank you.